And let's take a look now at how the polls are going in the city of San Juan. Our very own Rafael Bozano now joins us with the latest from there. Raf, what more can you tell us?
Hi, Carmina. From where we're standing, we can see that all precincts are almost filled. And the vote counting machines are working properly so far. Voters were allowed in the Savior School at 6:14 a.m. At first, the lines were short, but it didn't take long before more and more people arrived until the entire parking lot along Gate 4 of the Savior School was filled. This is still pretty much the situation until now. One of the first problems that we saw were some vote counting machines experienced paper jams. Technical staff explained that the machine wasn't aligned with the slot of the box that collected the ballots. This was eventually resolved, and the ballots that got jammed were eventually counted. Another challenge that we saw was the difficulty of some voters finding the right cluster. This inevitably delayed some of the voters, but people on the ground were quick to address this, and we did see that there are members or volunteers of the PPCRV who have set up a precinct finder at the ground floor of the Savior School. Now the queue downstairs is more systemic. There are also volunteers in the different areas that are ready to guide the voters to find their precincts and facilitate their voting. A lot of the voters we saw were carrying several sample ballots, so we went around to check if there was anyone giving them away, and indeed there were. We asked them why they were giving away sample ballots, but all they did was remain quiet as if nothing happened. Police also say that they saw three children giving away sample ballots near the polling center. A lot of personalities, both in showbiz and in politics, cast their vote here in the Savior School. At around 11:40, Mayor Francis Zamora voted. In 2019, he put an end to over two decades of leadership by the Ejercito Estrada family after beating Janela Estrada in the 2019 election. Janela and her father, Jingoy Estrada, are in line right now. We can see them from our vantage point to cast their vote. Jingoy is hoping to make a Senate comeback. His brother, JV Ejercito, who is also running for a Senate seat, voted earlier today together with his mother, former San Juan Mayor Gia Gomez. Now, compared to the 2016 elections, Carmina, the number of voters in San Juan increased to over 109,000. But despite this, it's still the area with the second least number of registered voters in the entire national capital region. Back to you.
All right, Raf, you know, we're about less than seven hours before the polls close. I was there earlier. The turnaround time then was 2 hours from entrance to voting. What's the turnaround time then? Because I understand more and more people are still going to troop to the polls to cast their vote today.
Yeah, when we saw each other earlier today, the turnaround time was between an hour and a half to 2 hours. But now, after fixing some of the problems and after realizing that that the lines would eventually shorten if they had opened more exit spaces and then putting up signs of the different clusters downstairs, I don't know if you were able to see it, but right now the lines do not span the entire school grounds, but rather just the front of Gate 4, so it's more systematic. A lot more people are now inside the parking lot under the shade, because the heat outside is scorching as of the moment. So that was one of the main concerns as to why they may have opted to open more entry and exit points, in order to help especially the senior citizens find shade amid the scorching heat, Carmina.
Yeah, all right. We're going to check in on you again a little bit later on as we go on with our coverage. In the meantime, we'd like to thank you, Rafael Bozano, there joining us live from the city of San Juan. Back here in the studio, another incident of a vote counting machine glitch was reported at a school in Marikina. Let's bring in our correspondent, Vivian Gulia, for more on this story. Viv, over to you.
Hi, Carmina. Several voters waited for at least 3 hours to cast their vote here at the elementary school cluster precinct. Apart from this long line of voters outside the precinct, another room filled with voters are waiting for their turn to fill their ballots. That's after the vote counting machine assigned to the precinct malfunctioned due to a paper jam when the first ballot was fed. While waiting for the VCM to be repaired, voters were given the option to leave their accomplished ballot, which will later be part of the batch feeding. The precinct's electoral board chairman assured voters the feeding of these ballots will be monitored by election watchers. Some agreed, but many chose to wait for the VCM to function again, which took more than 3 hours. One of them is Armando Aquino, who wants to make sure his vote for a leader he thinks is competent and has integrity will be counted. Another voter, Onay Manuel, says he waited long for this day to elect a leader who he believes will be good for his children and grandchildren's future. That is why he wants it to count. The precinct's electoral board assures affected voters they will entertain them as long as they are on the line before or by 7 p.m. Marikina First District Acting Election Officer Brian Buco says three other VCMs malfunctioned in other polling centers, one each in Barranca Elementary School, Santo Niño Elementary School, and Malanday Elementary School. Buco says while these machines passed the final testing and sealing, they failed to turn on this morning. The machines are still waiting to be repaired. In Monte Vista Subdivision, one voter expressed dismay after the vote counting machine did not read his accomplished ballot due to unnecessary mark. Carlos Poblador says he was casting his vote when the electric fan blew the ballot that touched the marker. They tried to feed the ballot into the VCM 4 times, but the machine refused to accept it. The incident has been reported to the local COMELEC. Buco says if the voter isn't at fault for the VCM's refusal to read his ballot, he can be given a new one. Another voter in the same precinct, Boboy Cortez, also laments that the VCM did not read his 84-year-old mother's ballot because the shade exceeded the oval. Cortez says they woke up early to vote, hoping to help elect a leader who will inspire good governance and, quote, bring back decency to the government. Meantime, rival candidates for Marikina City's mayoral race have both cast their votes. Marikina City First District Representative Bayani Fernando voted in Monte Vista, while incumbent Mayor Marcelino Teodoro voted here in San Roque Elementary School. Marcelino came with his wife Maan, who is running for First District Representative. Both mayoral candidates were in high spirits and expressed confidence they were able to remind people of their notable works during their respective mayoral stints. Over 260,000 Marikina residents registered to participate in the national and local polls this year. At the entrance of this polling center, voters undergo a temperature check. So far, 11 registered a temperature that exceeded the 37.5 degrees Celsius, but after resting for 5 minutes, their temperature returned to normal, which allowed them to vote in their precinct instead of the isolation polling place. That means that the isolation polling place here in San Roque Elementary School remains unused. Carmina, back to you.
Thanks a lot. Vivian Guglia there, joining us live from Marikina. Take care, Viv. Keep safe.